really liked making that Radiohead video, reacting to a bunch of random songs from them, so I figured I'd do this again. Doesn't look like there's any drops till this Friday with Tyler, the Creator's new album, so today we're going to be doing reacting to some of my favorite Joji songs. I've been following Joji since before even Ballads 1 came out, actually. I did not become a Filthy Frank fan until after Ballads, actually. Yeah. Anyways. So yeah, we're going to do that today. I'm excited.
What is love when the end is rolling in?
Honestly, Nectar is a full, like, album. This is the first track off that record. Is honestly not my favorite from Joji, but I have a lot of merchandise from it because, honestly, I love the merchandise that he put out. But this is such a great opening track. I just want to say that. Like, You is such an amazing opening track. It sounds so fresh, and, like, the production is unbelievable. Joji's vocals are unbelievable. I love this song so much. Like, every time I hear it, I'm just like, this is so good. Especially when the bass hits in, you're just like, whoa. You're, like, flying off to another planet. It is so good. I'm having a stroke. Lyrically, kind of just the basic, you know, he's kind of shocked. He's not enough, you know. I don't really understand why it's called You, to be cool. All right, next up we have Will He. This is, I think, the first song I heard from him, actually. I can't remember off the top of my head, to be quite specific, but I do remember hearing Slow Dancing in the Dark the first time, but I don't know if I remember anything before that. So I think it's either this or that, or Slow Dancing in the Dark. That was the first one I heard from him. So this song, honestly, lyrically is pretty bland. I'm gonna be quite honest with you. A lot of people hate In Tongues. I personally don't really actually have that much of a problem with the album. I love the lo-fi aesthetic it has. Yes, I understand his vocals are very like, okay, all right, fine. Fair. That's a fair argument, and I agree. But you know what? I still love the aesthetic of the album. You cannot deny that the album sounds how the cover looks. It's like you're drowning. And that's almost all the lyrics are like that. Joji's literally drowning on the cover. So I think that he did an excellent job at capturing what it was supposed to feel like, but I don't really know, like, lyrically. But anyways, not here to criticize In Tongues. I'm here to talk about how much I love this song. I, again, love the lo-fi aesthetic. It's so just, I mean, it's dreary and it's like you're just falling. It's like you're overdosing or something. I don't know. I don't even know what that feels like. No, I love this song. Definitely a good vibe for sad boy hours, you know? So, all right. We have my favorite song ever. Yes, favorite song ever. So, if I ever make a top 10 favorite song list, this will be number one. Unless something blows my mind again. But, we have Slow Dancing in the Dark. Which, I saw that, Idiot Rising when they do their, In the Clouds concerts. That's what they're called. they always end it with this song. Which is such a great choice. Because it's such a great, just, it's a great way to end something. Unfortunately, it wasn't the last song on the Ballads 1 record, which was a little odd, but whatever. Honestly, I still love all of his music a lot. I really do. Like, each song I don't honestly have an issue with a lot of his music like a lot of people do. I do agree that he is definitely capable of doing a lot more, and I'm glad to be able to be here to see Joji grow as an artist, you know? So, yeah, but this is probably, and I think most people agree, is his best song, and I mean, it's his biggest hit anyways, so. Let me mention one more thing quick, I'm sorry. This music video is like a cinematic masterpiece. It is so beautiful. Like, I will put this video in the description. It is stunning. It is so beautiful. Like, it honestly, almost every shot is a painting. Like, you know what I mean? Like, every frame of painting that is literally, I would frame so many shots from this. It is a beautiful, beautiful video. So good. Honestly, that song I've always read was like, I don't want to be alone, you know? Like, that's always how I've read that track, is like, I don't want to slow dance in the dark, because it's like, in the dark you can't see the person, it's like they're not there, you know? And the music video of him getting shot with an arrow, I think it kind of represents this, like, you can fall in love with someone, but maybe he feels like it's like you're just getting shot with an arrow, and it's, as you can see in the video, it's like it's taking time for him to bleed out and finally die. It's like that's how he feels love feels like. It's like you get shot, and you know, oh, it's, you know, oh my gosh, it's a lot to take in at first, and then slowly it just dissipates and dies off. That's always how I read the music video, and that's always how I've kind of read the song. Yeah, I think Joji's honestly, he's capable of making some great, great music, and I love him so much, honestly. He's just got this aesthetic with his music that is just unmatched. I love his vibes, I love his fashion sense too. I think honestly that guy knows how to dress cool. Much like Tyler the Creator too, for sure. And I'm super excited to see whatever else he puts out. I don't know when he's putting something out. I'm assuming the Head in the Clouds 3 is what I've been hearing as of me recording this. But Joji's a spectacular artist. Please do check it out. Check him out. Check the music video out too, because that is spectacular. Anyways, guys, please do like, share, and subscribe. Thank you for watching. And